Hi student, good morning. Today I am just going to discuss about the exercise 4.2. Last tak means after the last we have solved the exercise 4.1. That means from exercise 1.1 to exercise 4.1 have been already discussed and solved. Today I am going to discuss with you about exercise 4.2, that is solution of quadratic equation. I have sent in PDF version in the class 10 WhatsApp group. You just go through. I have given in writing everything what I am talking. That is solution of quadratic equation. The value of x or any variable, if we put in the LHS, means left hand side of a equation, then we must get the right hand side of that equation. Means if LHS and RHS are equal, then we can say that value of that variable satisfy the equation, means that value will be the zero or root of that equation. It is here clearly written, the value of x or any variable, if we put in LHS, then we must get RHS. Suppose example ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, LHS equal to ax square plus bx plus c and RHS equal to 0. If we put x equal to alpha in LHS, so we must get RHS equal to 0. If it is so, then x equal to alpha satisfy the equation. Same way, if we put x equal to beta and we see LHS equal to RHS, then we can say alpha and beta are the zeros or roots of the equation. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Normally it is a quadratic equation and it must have two zeros, okay? Because we have seen in a linear equation, zero of the equation is 1. For the quadratic equation, it will be 2. Example, see, it is given 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Andaje, imagination, if I put by imaginary, that is if I can imagine that x equal to plus 1, and if I put x equal to plus 1 in the equation, then I will get LHS equal to RHS. That means plus 1 will be the 1 0 of the equation. But from where we will get this another equation? Because it is quadratic equation, it must have two zeros. 1 0 if it is plus 1, and zero, another zero must be there. But by imagination we cannot do it. We have to calculate mathematically. That means calculation is needed so that you can find out value of x. Okay, so what to do? You have to do factorize, you have to do middle term factor, you have to do squaring the method, squaring the equation, means by squaring method also. Like this, one example is given, factorize or middle term factor, there is 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. First you have to do 2 into 3 equal to 6, and again factorize 6 equal to 2 into 3. Then do such a way that with the help of 2 and 3 we can get the middle term 5. We can get the middle term 5. That means you have to do sub addition or subtraction. Here we are doing 2x square minus 2 plus 3 whole into x plus 3 equal to 0. That means 2 plus 3 equal to 5. 5 ko aise break kar diya ki 2 or 3 ko add karke 5 mila. So after calculation we are getting x minus 1 whole into 2x minus 3 equal to 0. So remember, if equation a into b equal to 0, then either a equal to 0 or b equal to 0. Same here also, x minus 1 whole into 2x minus 3 equal to 0. So either x minus 1 equal to 0 or 2x minus 3 equal to 0. So here, if x minus 1 equal to 0, then x equal to 0. Or if 2x minus 3 equal to 0, x equal to 3 by 2. That means 1 and 3 by 2 are the roots and or zeros of the equation 2xx minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Now you can verify it. If you put x equal to 0, no, it must be, it is not 0. If x equal to 1, if you put x equal to 0, it is written here mistakenly, no, it will be x equal to 1. Just correct it. First line, verification. If you put x equal to 1 in equation 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0, then LHS equal to RHS. And if x equal to 3 by 2, then also LHS equal to RHS. So these two means x equal to 1 and x equal to 3 by 2, 1 and 3 by 2 will be the zeros of the equation 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Now once again I am requesting you, just make it amendment. It is mistakenly written. If you put x equal to 0, that is not 0. If you put x equal to 1, x equal to 1, repeat, x equal to 1. So cut that x equal to 0 and amend it, x equal to 1. So equation 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0, we are getting LHS equal to RHS. Now, thank you students. Now we are coming here exercise 4.2. They have asked find the zeros of x square minus 3x minus 10 equal to 0. In the same way, middle term factor, we are getting x square minus whole into 5 minus 2 into x minus 10 equal to 0, or after calculation we are getting x minus 5 into x plus 2 equal to 0. So either x minus 5 equal to 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0. If x minus 5 equal to 0, then x equal to 5. If x plus 2 equal to 0, then x equal to minus 2. So these 5 and minus 2 will be the roots of the given equation. That is answer. And you can very well check up this, whether LHS and RHS of the given equation or not. That means, अगर आपको दिखा गया कि ये x equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2 अलग अलग से बैठा के आप देखिए आपका given equation में LHS equal to RHS नहीं आ रहा है, तो आपका answer सही नहीं है. That means you have to check up, you have to verify whether if you put x equal to 5 or x equal to minus 2 separately in the given equation, then LHS or equal to RHS is coming or not. So separately you just put x equal to 5, then x square minus 3x minus 10 equal to x 5 square minus 3 into 5 minus 10 equal to 0, that is equal to right hand side. And separately if you put x equal to minus 2, then x square minus 3x minus 10 equal to minus 2 whole square minus 3 into minus 2 minus 10 equal to 4 plus 6 minus 10, that is equal to 0, that is equal to RHS. So it is verified both the case LHS equal to RHS. So it is confirmed that x equal to 5 and x equal to minus 2 are the roots of the given equation. Same way we are looking for 1, 3, root 2 x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 equal to 0. See, you have to multiply root 2 into 5 root 2 equal to 10. So again you factor it, means factor 10, that is equal to 5 plus 2. So that with the help of 5 and 2 we have to get 7 in the middle term. So here, or root 2 x square plus 2 x plus 5 x plus 5 root 2 equal to 0, or root 2 x into x plus root 2 plus 5 whole into x plus root 2 equal to 0, as in the middle term 2 from the root 2 x square plus 2 x, we are getting common root 2 x, x plus root 2, plus from the 5 x plus 5 root 2, 5 into x plus root 2. So we are getting x plus root 2 into root 2 x plus 5 equal to 0. So either x plus root 2 equal to 0 or root 2 plus either x plus root 2 equal to 0 or root 2 x plus 5 equal to 0. If x plus root 2 equal to 0, then x equal to minus root 2. If root 2 x plus 5 equal to 0, then x equal to minus 5 by root 2. So rationalize it, because in the bottom must not be a root over. So it becomes minus 5 root 2 by 2, means you are multiplying minus 5 by root 2 with root 2 by root 2. That means it becomes minus 5 root 2 by 2. So roots of the given equations are minus 2 and minus 5 root 2 by 2. Now come to 1, 4, 2 x square minus x plus 1 by 8 equal to 0. You can do it two different way, either squaring it or by factorizing it. Factorizing it means just add it, LCM 8 means 16x square minus 8x plus 1 by 8 equal to 0. So one step jump is there, so that 8 will be going in the right hand side, 8 into 0, and that becomes 0. So one step jump is there, 16x square minus 8x plus 1 equal to 0. Or 16x square minus 4x minus 4x plus 1 equal to 0, because 16 ko aapne toda hai, aapne factorize kiya 4 into 4. With the help of this 4 and 4, we have to get middle term 8. So see this 16x square minus 4x minus 4x plus 1 equal to 0, or 4x common, 4x minus 1 minus 1 common 4x minus 1. So 4x minus 1 into whole into 4x minus 1 equal to 0, and both the case x equal to 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 are the roots of the given equation 2x square minus x plus 1 by 8 equal to 0. you can say in, you can do it in another way by squaring method, that is 16x square minus 8x plus 1 equal to 0 and 4x whole square minus 2 into 4x into 1 plus 1 whole square equal to 0. That means a square minus 2ab plus b square formula. That means 4x minus 1 whole square equal to 0 or 4x minus 1 whole into 4x minus 1 equal to 0. So both the case we are getting 4x minus 1 equal to 0 and again 4x minus 1 equal to 0. So x equal to 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 are the roots of the given equation. That is the answer. Thank you, dosto. Next come to question number 3, exercise 4.2, that is question number 3. It is given that the sum of two numbers is 27 and product is 182. So find the numbers. Here you have to let first number is x and second number is y. So sum by the condition, sum is x plus y equal to 27. Or you can do it again, y equal to 27 minus x, that is your choice. I have kept it x plus y equal to 27 as a number one equation. Second case, by the second condition, product of them is equal to 182. That means xy equal to 182. That means x into 27 माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू 182 कैसे मिला आपको ना एक नंबर इक्वेशन से आप वाई इक्वल टू 27 माइनस एक्स निकाल लो जस्ट गेट इट फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन नंबर वन एक्स वाई इक्वल टू 27 माइनस एक्स एंड पुट दैट वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इन एक्स वाई इक्वल टू 182 सो यू आर गेटिंग एक्स इंटू 27 माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू 182 और 27 माइनस एक्स minus x square equal to 182 or x square minus 27x plus 182 equal to 0 or x minus 13 into x minus 14 you will be getting equal to 0 by the help of middle term factor because 182 has the factors of 13 and 14 that means x minus 13 whole into x minus 14 equal to 0. So if x minus 13 equal to 0, then x equal to 13. And put this x equal to 13 in equation 1, you will get x plus y equal to 27 or y equal to 14. That means 13 and 14 are the two numbers. Again, if x minus 14 equal to 0, then x equal to 14. This x equal to 14, you put this in equation number 1, then you will be getting y equal to 13. In any case, you are getting x equal to 13, y equal to 14 or x equal to 14, y equal to 13. That means we understand that the two numbers are 14 and 13. Therefore, two numbers are 13 and 14 or 14 and 13. That means only 13 and 14 or 14 and 13. The two numbers only 13 and 14. This is the answer. Thank you, student. Number 4. After that, question number 5 you have to do. The altitude of a right angle triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides of the right angle triangle. See this. From the book, I have taken out the exercise 4.2 and you just watch question number 5.
इट इज क्लियरली रिटन ये कि या कि एक राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल का 7 सेंटीमीटर लेस देन द बेस अगर अल्टीट्यूड होता है और हाइपोटेन्यूज 13 सेंटीमीटर है, उसका आधा टू साइड्स निकालने के लिए बोला है. द क्वेश्चन हैज़ टोल्ड, द क्वेश्चन हैज़ आस्क्ड, फाइंड इट्स आधा टू साइड्स कंडीशन गिवन. टू कंडीशन गिवन, वन इज अल्टीट्यूड ऑफ द राइट एंगल इज 7 सेंटीमीटर लेस देन इट्स बेस एंड सेकेंड कंडीशन इज इट्स हाइपोटेन्यूज इज 13 सेंटीमीटर. इट इज़ वेरी इजी, ओनली राइट डाउन द पाइथागोरस थ्योरम दैट इज बेस स्क्वायर प्लस हाइट स्क्वायर इक्वल टू हाइपोटेन्यूज स्क्वायर दैट मीन्स of a right angle triangle. From there you will get it. Just see question number 5, answer 5. I have drawn one triangle ABC right angle triangle at right angle at B. Its hypotenuse AC equal to 13 centimeter and let its base is x centimeter. So BC is equal to x and AB equal to x minus 7. By Pythagoras theorem, x square plus x minus 7 whole square equal to 13 square. X minus 7 whole square is equal to simplify कर लीजिए. X square plus x square minus 14x plus 49. That is equal to 169. So after calculation, we are getting x square minus 7x equal to 60, or x square equal to 7x minus 60. That is equal to equation x square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 0. After that, you do it factorize middle term factor 12 को लाने के लिए. Okay. 60 you have to factorize 60 that is 12 into 5 that means minus 12 plus 5 equal to minus 7 middle term factor is minus 7 so we are getting x minus 12 into x plus 5 equal to 0 so it will be x equal to 12 and when x equal to minus 5 that means this will be for your homework. I have done it up to this x minus 12 into x plus 5 equal to 0. Okay, from there you need to find out the base is x equal to how much. And from there, if you are getting x equal to how much, then just 7 less than that value of x will be the altitude. I have not done it. It is your homework. From this solution, x minus 12 whole into x plus 5 equal to 0. You have to write either x minus 12 equal to 0 or x plus 5 equal to 0. If you are taking x minus 12 equal to 0, then x will be 12, means base will be 12 and altitude will be 12 minus 7 equal to 5. Okay? Then if x plus 5 equal to 0, that time x will be minus 5. Can you think that any length of a triangle will be the minus 5? If you think that it can be, then you put x equal to minus 5 in the left hand side of the equation we have got x square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 0. If you put minus 5, then you will get 25 minus 35 minus 60. That doesn't become left right hand side equal to 0. So in one thing, direct you can say length of any side of a triangle cannot be negative. So you write down x not equal to minus 5. So we are getting x equal to 12, that is base equal to 12 centimeter, and your altitude will be 7 less than 12, that is 12 minus 7 equal to 5 centimeter. That is the answer. That will be the answer. Thank you. Next. Next come to question 6. It is written, a cottage industry produces a certain number of pottery articles in a day. It was observed that on a particular day, cost of production of each article in rupees was 3 more than twice the number of article produced in a day. If the total cost of production on that day is 90 rupees, find the number of articles produced and the cost of each article. That means here question is asking, find the number of article produced in a day and the cost of each article. So we will let the number of articles produced, just see, number of article produced in a day equal to x, and cost of each article equal to twice x plus 3, because it is told it is twice of the article produced plus 3. 3 more means plus 3. So if you let it number of article produced equal to x, then cost of each article will be 2x plus 3. So cost of production equal to 90, it is given. So by condition we are getting product of article produced and total cost of the article equal to 90. So we are getting x into twice x plus 3 equal to 90, or 2x square plus 3x minus 90 equal to 0. So now do 90 into 2 equal to 180. 180 factorize equal to 15 into 12. So with the help of 15 and 12, by adding or subtraction we have to get 3 middle term, because it is a middle term factor. So 2x square plus 15x minus 12x. So we are doing subtraction from 15 to 12. We are writing now 2x square plus 15x minus 12x minus 90 equal to 0, or you will be getting 2x plus 15 into x minus 6 whole into equal to 0. That means after calculation, after taking common from two terms, then you will be getting 2x plus 15 whole into x minus 6 equal to 0. So either 2x plus 15 equal to 0 or x minus 6 equal to 0. If you are taking 2x plus 15 equal to 0, then you will be getting x equal to minus 15 by 2. But it cannot be, because as article produced cannot be negative, so you must write x not equal to minus 15 by 2. So therefore we are getting x minus 6 equal to 0, or x equal to 6. So article produced equal to 6 and cost of each article equal to 2x plus 3 equal to 2 into 6 plus 3 equal to 15. how you are taking this? You are putting just x equal to 6 in this 2x plus 3. So it becomes 2 into 6 plus 3 equal to 15. This is the answer. Thank you, dosto. Subscribe my channel. For class 10 it is only. It is for class 10, exercise 4.2. Thank you. Students, ये जो YouTube चैनल है, please subscribe my YouTube channel. So that as soon as any problem or solution I am uploading, it will reach to you. Thank you.